So, now I know where you were made. I hope. Good morning.
Morning. What a great shower. I feel a lot better.
Did you sleep well? This is a very small couch.
Oh, no, it wasn't too bad at all. I feel great, thanks.
Well, I'm glad you were here. I felt very safe. Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm glad I was here, too.
I'm going to make some brunch. Would you like to sit down?
Brunch? Yeah, sure. Thanks. That sounds good.
I was getting just a little bit frustrated with that list. I bet we had at least 50 names until we found our Cien Albel.
Well, as they say, if at first you don't succeed...
But we did. We found our man, and he makes music boxes. So, let's go to Quebec.
I definitely think we should go to Quebec.
Okay, let's eat something and then we can start packing.
I think we should go to Quebec, but not right now.
Why not?
Well, I don't think it would be a good idea to just rush off without being prepared.
Prepared? Oh, Colton, I've been saying this over and over and over again. I am prepared. I want to go to Quebec. I'm as prepared as I'll ever be.
Okay, wait a minute, wait
a minute. No, I don't want to wait.
Let's just talk it over, okay?
What?
I want to think this through completely.
Okay, what's the point?
Well, actually, I have a couple of them.
Oh, Colton.
Okay, first of all, I think we should sit down with a map, plot out every single move that we're going to make.
We could do that on the airplane.
Secondly, we don't have reservations.
Well, easily remedied.
Thirdly, it's the 4th of July. Nobody's going to be open.
Canada doesn't have a 4th of July Independence Day.
We should wait for Sean, and probably Colette, too.
We don't know where they are.
Sean is going to check in, I'm sure. And Colette will show up.
We don't need them. We can be there and be back before they come here. So, let's go. Oh, unless you want me to go by myself.
You cannot think that I would let you go off by yourself.
Well, come on then, let's go.
Felicia, I care about you a lot. I would do anything for you.
I know.
But not this.
Why?
Because there is something about that music box that we don't know. And it's putting your life in jeopardy. It's making you a target.
What difference does it make if I'm a target here or if I'm a target in Quebec?
Well, for one thing, you've got friends here.
Well, what difference does that make? If somebody's after me, they're going to know where I'm going to be, and my friends aren't going to be able to help.
I just think that it'll be a lot easier for these people to get a hold of you in Quebec than it would be here.
You'd be able to help me, wouldn't you?
Well, yes, I'll be there, but I can't stop bullets.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Okay. Okay, so when do you expect to hear from Sean?
I don't know. He really didn't say.
So we're supposed to just sit around and wait for him?
Yeah, but I'm sure he'll be back in a couple of days.
Couple of days? What are we supposed to do in the meantime?
Well, it's 4th of July. We could celebrate.
No, I don't feel much like celebrating.
Come on, it'll be good for us. Make the time go by faster.
What did you have in mind?
Well, I did kind of say that I was going to drop by the docks. Everybody's having a picnic down there.
Docks?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it'd be fun. It'd be a great place to watch the fireworks.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'll put a few things in a basket.
Good.
Pretzels.
Pretzels. Yeah.
Thank you for saving my life when that horrible Mr. LeBlanc took Crystal's wedding ring.
Yeah, about 1,000 times, actually.
Oh, I'm doing it again.
Okay, 1,001. The debt is paid. Now let's get packing, okay? Do you have a basket?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sorry. Yeah.
Tonight, we are going to play Pass the Orange and the Port Charles River version of, would you believe it, the Egg and Spoon Race. And now, let me introduce the game master of ceremonies, our own TV celebrity, Colton Shore.
Come on! right along.
All right. Hi, everybody.
Here he is.
Happy 4th of July. All right. I have no idea what we're going to do here. I will just make it up as I go along.
That's the way. Pass the orange.
All right. Pass the orange. We're going to have teams, let's see, probably comprised of mostly General Hospital people. Most, not everybody. Let's see, we'll have Patrick and Amy, Walt and Sam, Louise and Tom, and AJ, and Terry volunteers. Oh, come on up, everybody. And we'll go over some of the rules. Go. All right, now everybody gather around and we'll try and get these rules squared away so nobody ends up cheating. And I want to keep my eye on you, especially.
Oh, no. Get over here.
Okay, we're going to have two sets of teams. All right, and does everybody know how to play this game?
Yeah, I'll tell us
how. All right, okay. Put your orange under your chin like this, right? And then you come to the person that you're teamed up with and...
Woo! I don't think that's exactly how you play the game.
All right, and to make this more interesting, I'm not going to pair you up with the person that you came with, okay? I want you to find somebody else, not the person you came with. We're going to split up. The guys over here, the girls over here, get into two different lines, all right? And the first team to make an exchange is the winner. Mr. Rooney is going to be standing here with a stopwatch, keeping track of everybody's time, so we'll know who has the best overall time for the night. And then we'll get a winner. Everybody clear on all that?
Yeah.
All right, let's get squared off. Girls over here, guys over there. Break up into two separate lines. All right, who's going to start? Louise, think fast. Amy, here you go. Okay, everybody set? Everybody got a good seat? Oh, yeah, remember to keep your hands behind your back. If I see anybody using their hands, they're out of here. I'm just kidding. You ready, Mr. Rooney?
Ready.
Everybody ready?
This is
set. Set. Go.
Go.
I can hardly wait for the fireworks to start.
Do we need them?
Meaning?
There's always fireworks coming with you.
This is great.
Just happen to have it in the freezer.
Homemade.
First of all.
A woman of so many talents.
I wonder when the fireworks are starting.
I don't know. Where are those clouds you're rolling fast? Hope it doesn't rain.
To call you back. Somebody's at the door. Okay, thank you. Oh, hi.
Good morning. I just went out for some donuts for a change. I thought maybe we could have a couple and then I'll walk you to work.
Well, that's nice. I have some coffee on the stove. Help yourself.
Great.
I'll get dressed.
All right. They heard you talking to somebody when I came up to the door. Were you on the phone?
Oh, it was just a charity thing.
Oh. You, trying to tell me something?
What?
You've got the word now written all over this list. I presume that means you want to go to Quebec now, huh?
If Sean doesn't get back by today, then forget him.
What?
Would you sit me up, please?
Yeah, sure. Forget him. Boy, Sean would sure be hurt if he heard you say that.
I didn't mean it personally. You know that. Now, it would make a lot of difference if there was a lot going on. But since Sean is out of town, and Anna keeps going to and from New York, and frankly, she's having some family problems, whenever I go to work, there's nothing to do. I just stare at the walls, and the phones never ring.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm surprised they haven't gone out of business by now.
Well, they're professionals. When people call, they're in demand. Anyway, if Sean did call, then it would...
You know, the thing about Sean, I want you to remember, he went to Washington to find out more about the music box.
I know, but how long is it going to take? We can't just sit around here and twiddle our thumbs waiting for him to come back from Washington when I know I can go to Quebec and find out more information anyway.
No, you don't know that for sure, and Sean has a lot of contacts that we don't have.
Yes, but we know who made the music box, and we don't need contacts.
Well, Sean has a lot of experience, and there is no substitute for experience.
Okay. Okay, you win. We'll wait for him.
Good.
Did you hear what happened last night at Duke's Club?
Mm-mm, what?
At Indiana,
it got flooded.
You're kidding. How'd that happen?
Well, I don't know. I was just going to watch Tiffany's news to see if she had any stories.
It's believed that the political dignitaries were the
target of the bombing.
Sounds like
all she's talking about is terrorism.
And that this is the work of the underground.
This is the international news. I'll have to wait for the local news later. Anyway, I have to get to work.
Wait a minute. What about your donuts?
Well, I'll take my donuts, and I'll have coffee at work.
All right. Fair enough.
Well, anyway, Terry was telling me that everybody was out on the dance floor and water came rushing in. It was going every which way. Everybody was just running everywhere.
They have no idea how it started?
Well, apparently not.
It must have been a lot of fun.
You're putting me on.
Now, why would I do a thing like that?
Amy can't leave for the hospital. It's too early. She's always running around here like a chicken with her head cut off trying to get to work on time.
Kid you not, she was dressed, sat down, had a leisurely breakfast, walked to the hospital.
Amy?
Amy.
I don't believe it. I just don't believe it. Hi, Tiffany!
Hi, how you doing, Patrick? Hi, Ruth.
Hi, honey. I turned on the morning news and you weren't on it.
Oh, well, I did the national and I did the world news and I let Howard take care of the local news. Guess what? I'm going to have to buy my own breakfast today because Sean is out of town.
Well, then I'll just have to keep my prices down.
Well, I wish you would. You know, that man is driving me absolutely batty, but I don't want to talk about him. I want a black cup of coffee, nice and hot, please.
And you call that running up a tab?
Well, I'm just getting started. You know, we'll send the tab to Sean. I have a report to read. Could I just take this table right over here?
Sure, honey.
Great. If you just give me a donut... Oh, I love it. A donut, and I'll take my own coffee, and I'll just sit down and get out of your way.
Be my guest.
Thank you. This is... I'm so wired for so early in the morning, aren't I?
You know, as much as I love my flat at the Brownstone, I really do, I truly miss Sean's place. I mean, there was always so much fun and excitement there.
Oh, yeah, well, with Sean and Robert, there's always a laugh a minute and always something going on, you know?
And Cheryl Stansbury.
Yeah.
And that other strange girl.
I don't know. Who are you talking about? What strange girl?
Oh, I've only seen her a couple of times, but every time I see her, she's a different color.
Oh, come again?
Where?
No, I mean, repeat what you just said. What do you mean she's a different color? What are you talking about?
It's the hair. That's what it is. I mean, black, then brown, then whitish yellow, like cornflakes, you know? I mean, very, very strange.
How many times have you seen her at Sean's?
Oh... I can't be sure. Maybe 3 times I've seen her, but I can't say for sure.
Does she wear maybe like a strong perfume?
Oh, my goodness, does she what? I mean, her aroma lingers and lingers like stale beer in a pub.
Uh-huh.
Here we are. Toast.
Oh, thanks, Ruth.
You're welcome. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
Dry toast? You're dry?
Oh, yes. I always have it for breakfast.
Well, why don't you try a little butter, maybe jelly, you know, a little grape jelly?
Oh, no, we have to watch our girlish figures, eh?
Well, I'd rather kind of broad the beam myself.
Beam?
The hips, sweetheart, the hips.
Beam hip. Fancy that.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know, I've been meaning to ask you, is Sean out of town?
Yeah, as far as I know, he is.
Oh, I do think it's so thrilling, all that under-the-covers work he does, you know.
Yes, well...
Did he go off on a new adventure by himself?
Well, you know, he didn't say. Prunella, I've got to go to the station and make sure they've changed the gel lights. I'll see you later, okay?
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
Jimmy on lights. Oh, these show business people are almost as odd as those that work under the covers. What happened?
Oh, hi. Bit of a mess.
Did somebody break in?
No, I wanted to change the decor.
Is anything missing?
I don't think so, not as far as I can tell.
This is strange.
I don't know.
What do you want me to do?
Oh, you could help file those things over there. Bring them here.
Why didn't you call me in earlier? I could have come in and helped.
It's all right.
When did this happen?
I don't know. I think the 4th of July. I found out about it yesterday.
And you don't know who did it or why?
Unhappy client. I don't know.
That's weird. Did I tell you that Sean went to Washington?
Is that what he...
Yeah.
Oh. No. We haven't seen each other lately.
That's probably my fault.
It's not your fault. How do you feel after your fall?
Well, I have a bruise on my head, but other than that, I'm fine.
Yeah. Good. You know that music box? Do you think Frisco really sent it to you?
No. I think that he sent it to somebody and somebody sent it to me.
Oh, I see.
I know that he's gone. I know that he's dead. I just want to see his grave. Do you think that's being unreasonable?
No, not at all. I think whatever we do for memory... I don't think that's unreasonable at all. No.
It's what a... Whoa, hello. What does the audience list look like today?
Well, we'll have a full house as usual.
No, I mean, what type of an audience is it? I mean, is it young or older or what?
Well, it's pretty evenly divided between the teenagers and the adults, even though the kids are out of school.
Good. I like a mixed audience. Makes things more interesting.
That's for sure.
You know, I would love to get an aisle put in here so I can maybe walk down the middle. Did we get any response to last week's show?
Oh, it was terrific. I mean, we got lots of favorable phone calls, and we got piles and piles of mail. The viewers really like those themes, those word games that you play.
Yeah? Okay, good. I'll keep that in mind.
Guys, hello. I'm back. I'm all ready. Where's my schedule and what are our problems we have to work out for today? Tell me.
Relax. Tell you what. I'll give you a visual image. Imagine yourself as the calm at the eye of the storm.
Darling, I am the storm. Now tell me, what?
Well, Terry won't be here today. She has a cold.
Don't tell me that. I don't believe it.
We'll use a tape of the theme.
That's good. Tell me that. Okay, what about the engineering crew? Are they all set?
Yes.
Okay, what about Cheryl?
I tried to reach her. I've been able to get in touch with her.
Keep working on her. We got to have her here. Did you talk to Felicia? Is she coming, Colton?
Oh, no, I forgot. But I'll get a hold of her.
Would you like some coffee?
Gallons of coffee, please.
I'm actually... pretty much set for today. Much better shape than usual.
Where's Sean?
He's in Washington.
I know that's what he told me, but you never can tell with him. I want the truth, Colton. Tell me the truth. Did he go alone? Well, did he? Colton, just tell me, did Sean go to Washington alone?
What kind of a question is that?
It's quite simple. Did he go alone?
Do you think that he... He didn't?
Please don't dance around this question, okay?
As far as I know, he went alone.
And what exactly does that mean?
Exactly what I said. He didn't tell me he was going with anybody, but I didn't put him on the plane.
Look, Charlton, I don't mean to badger you about this. Do you happen to know a woman that has, like, multicolored hair?
What?
She wears wigs, obviously. One day she's got black hair, and then she's got blonde, probably blue and green.
Convertible top, huh?
Yeah, do you know a woman like that?
Let me see. Yeah. Oh, okay, thank you. Excuse me. Colton Shore.
Hi, it's Felicia.
Oh, hi.
Somebody broke into Anna's office and made a really big mess.
You're kidding. Are you all right? Is Anna all right?
Well, yes. But I've got to stay here and help her clean up, so I won't be able to come over to the show.
Oh, well, that's all right. I understand. Was anything taken?
No. But that's what's so strange. I don't know if it was intended for me or if it was intended for Anna.
I don't understand what you mean.
Well, maybe they're looking for the music box.
Music box? No, I don't think so, Felicia. I mean, if your desk had been broken into, and that'd be one thing, but why would they go into Anna's office?
But they don't know where I'm sitting.
Okay, listen, I can understand why you're paranoid, but I really think that this is something else unrelated. I wouldn't worry about it.
I hope you're right.
Okay, well, listen, I'm going to be done with the show, and I can come over and help you clean up if you'd like.
Oh, no, thank you. The files are confidential. We'll manage. I'll talk to you later, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Goodbye.
Bye. No way am I going to get into this with Tiffany about Colette.
Hi, I have an appointment.
Oh, when will you be back?
I don't think I will be today. Just finish up whatever you're doing and close up.
What about the file folders and things?
Oh. Well, we better leave those. We'll have to do them together.
Okay.
I'll see you later.
All right, bye-bye. Okay. Yes, I'd like to make a reservation on our next flight to Quebec. My name is Felicia Jones.
That'll work. The theme for today's show is cliches. Cliches like tomorrow's the first day of the rest of your life. Rolling stone gathers no moss. He who hesitates is lost. I like this. Okay. We've all heard about cliches. We all use them every day. Penny saved is a penny earned, and there's another one. Where do these come from? They all have a basis in truth. Seems like the list is endless. So I wish I could come up with a few more. You guys, I need some help here. I need some.
Hi.
I don't have any cliches. Hello.
You about ready for today's show?
Yeah, I think so, pretty much. Have a seat.
Oh, did you walk in touch with Felicia?
She said that Anna's office was broken into and she's got to stay there and clean things up.
Are you kidding?
No.
First Duke's is like flooded like a swimming pool and then somebody tries to do a number on Anna's. Either Duke and Anna are under a black cloud or somebody I think is trying to tell them something. What do you think?
Yeah, it kind of seems that way, doesn't it?
Yeah. Did you ever tell me where Sean went?
Hello? Got a little bit on your mind today,
too? Yeah, I did. What?
I told you that Sean is in Washington, and I did everything but put him on the plane. Does that ring a bell?
Yes, I'm sorry. I do have a lot on my mind.
I understand. Tell you what I'll do. If I hear from Sean first, I'll tell him you're looking for him, okay?
Oh, please do that, okay?
I promise.
Thank you.
See you later.
Okay.
Okay, back to the cliches. I'll come up with some more. Early to bed, early to rise. Makes a man healthy, wealthy, and wise. You hope, anyway. I really should give her a call. Just don't feel right.
Donnelly investigations. No one's in at the moment, but please leave a...
Why would she be gone? She told me she was going to be cleaning up the office. Well, try her at home. Can't imagine why she'd be there. Yep, she would. I got a phone book. Bingo. Holy shit. I better be wrong about this. Airlines are not. Hello. Yes, could you tell me when your next flight to Quebec is, please?
It's flight 64, and it leaves in 20 minutes.
20 minutes. Could you tell me if there's a Felicia Jones on that flight?
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. We cannot give you that information.
I understand, but this is my wife, and there's a medical emergency in the family. I have to talk to her.
I'm sorry. I'd like to give her your message, but...
That's all right. Thank you very much. She's on a flight. I can't believe this. Dip! I gotta go. Sorry.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. What? What were you...
Do a rerun. I've gotta go. It's an emergency.
What? What?
Please make sure that your seatbelts are fastened. We'll be leaving in a moment, and we'll do everything we can to make your flight to Quebec a pleasant one.
Remind me to send you an autographed copy of my last week's show.
What do you mean?
It was about determination, perseverance, and stubbornness. And those words fit you to a T.
Me?
Who, me? Yeah, you.
Hmm. How'd you know I was on this flight?
Determination, perseverance, and stubbornness.
I'm glad you're as bad as me. Here we come.
On schedule. Please let the cabin attendants know if there is anything we can do to make your flight more enjoyable.
I don't want enjoyable. I want successful.
Did it ever occur to you that this trip might be more successful if we did things Sean's way?
Maybe.
Then why did you try ducking out on us and running off to Quebec all by yourself?
I wasn't ducking out on you. I just knew you'd try to stop me.
I have to say, I was awfully glad that you showed up. How did you know I was out here anyway?
Well, you told me that you were going to be in Anna's office cleaning things up, remember?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I called back there, and the only thing working in that office was the answering machine.
How did you know I was on this particular flight?
Well, I figured that the only thing that would make you lie to me would be this trip to Quebec.
I'm sorry. I just knew that you'd try to talk me out of it, and I knew Sean would try to talk me out of it.
Well, there are very good reasons that Sean and I were trying to talk you out of this. This trip could be very dangerous.
I have to do this. I have to find out what happened to Frisco.
You know, the theme of my show today was going to be about cliches. You ever heard the one about curiosity killing the cat?
Of course.
Well, you don't have 9 lives.
I get your message. I know you saved my life once, and I may not be so lucky the next time.
Yes. I've been trying to reach you since this morning.
Well, now you've reached me.
We've got to make our move, and fast.
Hey, I make the decisions.
Well, you better make this one in a hurry. Unless I miss my guess, this Felicia Jones woman is on her way to Quebec right now.
Been waiting for your call.
Donnelly? Is this Sean Donnelly?
Yeah, it's me, Kinley.
You know, you and your friend, Mrs. Jones, have caused a lot of problems for me.
Oh, come on, Jimbo. That's the way you play the game. If you don't learn how to protect your back, better get out of the business. Just feel glad that all they did was demote you, huh?
We gotta talk.
All right, talk. Now and here.
No. Not over the phone. It's too dangerous.
Look, Kinley, there is a very, very special young lady involved here, and her life is at stake.
Yeah, I already told her too much.
I agree, you did.
But now you may as well go all the way. What have you got to lose? You're
already on the Bureau's bad boy list. You want to be on mine, too? Come on, now. You called
me. What do you want?
Kinley, I know you're there. I can hear you sweating.
All right. Not over the phone. I'll meet you in DuPont Park in 20 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the captain requests that you fasten your seatbelts and return your seats to their upright position as we begin our approach to landing in Quebec.
You know, with Sean in Washington and Anna having so many problems with Duke, I feel kind of guilty about leaving the office.
But not very.
What do you mean, not very?
Not very guilty.
That's not fair.
But is it true?
Well, I do feel guilty, but not too guilty to stay home, I guess.
How about guilty enough to let me find you a safe place to stay while I go to this CNL doll shop by myself this afternoon?
Not a chance. Nothing is going to stop me. Nobody. Not guilt, not even fear.
Fear?
Well, yeah, I was easy getting on this plane, but now I'm getting scared to death.
Okay, then. What do you say we take the next flight home?
Nice try, but not a chance. I'm not leaving this place until I find out what happened to Frisco.
We fix the problem, n'est-ce pas? The jewel, it is loose. Un peu, little loose. You leave avec moi. The ring, pick up demain. Tomorrow, no?
Will it be safe? It's an antique.
Oh, mais oui, safe, of course. I give you a seat.
You think it's okay to leave it here overnight?
It's a safe neighborhood.
Très bien. Demain dans le matin. How you say? In the morning. Voilà.
Thank you.
Merci. Au revoir.
Un moment, s'il vous plaît.
Mon Dieu. Just kidding.
Do you mind stepping in the back room, please?
Money.
It's not a robbery. We don't want your money. Just step in the back room.
No stealing. Je ne comprends pas.
Just go.
Monsieur, I do not understand.
Move it.
The money.
Go.
Move it. Monsieur, I go.
Sorry, sir. Can you help me? Baby's diaper, you know.
Oh, sure.
Can you hold the doll while I change it? He's big, but he's not mean or anything.
Well, that's all right. Take your time.
Hey. Hey, you are a cute dog. Look at you. Look at you. You're toughy, too, aren't you?
Hey, you can't handle that dog. Why don't you get a poodle?
Hey, why don't you just put a leash on your mouth, huh?
Easy, boy, easy. Ma'am? Ma'am, your dog. Ma'am?
Easy, boy, easy. Went a little overboard with your disguise, didn't you?
Oh, come on, the dog's not mine. Lady with a baby asked me to watch it for her.
Yeah, so where's the lady?
Well, she seems to have wandered off, that's all.
Yeah, or else you got made, Donnelly. This smells like a trap to me.
Hey, come on, don't get paranoid on me, all right?
Look, I think I better get going.
Will you just wait here for a minute, okay? Just wait here. Ma'am? Ma'am, oh, there you are.
He didn't give you any trouble, did he?
Oh, no, no, that's a terrific dog.
Thank you so much. He hates it when I have to tie him up.
Oh, you're welcome, yeah. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Okay, here, you need some help?
Come on.
There you go.
Come on.
This is terrific, really terrific. Come on. Kinley, you are chicken. Sure is.
Colton's not even that late.
Well, maybe, I don't know, he could have gone to a late lunch or ran some errands or something. It looks kind of like a one-man operation.
Well, he'll be back. We'll just have to wait then.
On the other hand, it might be open only half days or something. We could be here all night. Let's just come back tomorrow morning when we know he's
open. No. I'm not coming back tomorrow. You can go to the park instead if you want. I'll wait here alone.
Hey, wait a minute. I'm on your team, remember? I'm not the enemy.
I'm sorry, we can just go somewhere and kill some time if you like.
Okay, great. Let's go grab a bite to eat. Besides, we need to find a place to stay tonight, okay?
You promised to come back today.
I promise. Come on.
Okay.
I swear!
I'll ask you again, do you remember this man?
No, I told you. This man I do not know.
Refresh his memory.
I swear!
Ease up on him. Go get a music box. It is not our intention to harm you, and I do not like to inflict pain. But there is certain information we must know. If you have it, you will tell us. If you do not, then I'm sorry to tell you, we must know that as well. No matter how much pain it causes you. This music box and the ones you have here, do you make them here?
No, only sell.
Then where do you get them?
They ship them to me.
Who manufactures these?
A company called C.N. Albel, same as this place.
And where is this C.N. Albel company?
I don't know. They ship them, I sell them.
No!
I'm telling the truth to you. I talk to them only by telephone.
Study this sketch. It's similar to the boxes you sell here. How is it different?
How can I tell from this?
Look at it carefully. Study it very carefully.
I see nothing. The knob. We... In the picture. There is no knob. No knob.
You've done well, thank you. For your trouble. And a reminder, you tell no one what happened here today. If you tell anybody anything, we'll be back. Not only to take the money, but to take your life as well. I suggest you remain closed for the rest of the day.
Checked out the woman with the dog. It's no setup. Let's talk. So were you surprised to hear from me?
No, not when you told me you were still in Washington.
What does that mean?
Well, it's a surefire tip that you've got information needed at higher levels.
Yeah, I've still got some information that makes me useful, yeah. And some of the agents are still contacting me. They've been so deep undercover that they don't know what's happened.
Tell me something, Kinley. What do you know about this fake interrogation the Bureau put Felicia and me through right after we broke into your office?
I had my own problems with the Bureau. I don't know what happened to you.
What do you know about the music box?
The music box? Was made by a CN Albel for Frisco.
What for?
Hey, look, we don't have time to talk about that. You and Felicia are in serious jeopardy here.
If she has been in jeopardy ever since she laid eyes on LeBlanc.
There's something that you ought to know about someone.
Oh, come on, man. Don't stop now. Tell me, what is it? Kinley, let's not draw this thing out, huh? Come on, Kin.
It's open at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. We'll just come back. Now we can go find a place to spend the night.
Well, there must be something else we can do today.
Like what?
Well, we could try to find the explosion site where Frisco was last seen.
The only problem with that is that we're not exactly sure when or where the explosion occurred.
We must be able to get some information somehow.
Okay. Go to the library, look through some old newspapers, see if we can find a story written about the explosion. I'm sure somebody must have picked it up. Then once we have an idea of the time and the place, we'll go to the police. Okay?
Okay, that's
good. All right.
remember, old man, not a word about our visit to anybody. Good night.
Sure is closed, but it'll be open tomorrow morning at 10 a.m.
Yeah, and we'll be waiting.
Reporters didn't hear any rumors about the explosion that LeBlanc said the Frisco was in.
Well, the thing is that explosion could have happened anywhere. I mean, out in the middle of the sticks or some remote spot. This is a big country, you know.
I was just hoping for some good luck for a change.
For a change? Hey, we found C and Al Bell, didn't we?
Well, it's 9:55. We still have a few more minutes.
Yeah, if they open on time.
They'd better.
Former WSB agent James Kinley was found dead last night, slumped on a park bench. No signs of violence were apparent, according to sources. And police have declined to comment on rumored evidence that the death was a homicide. Oh, come on, guys. Sources say a small amount of blood found on the back of his neck suggests possible injection of poison. Of course, it's poison. What else can it be? The old dark game. Oh, Kinley, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I had to leave you like that. I just wish you would have talked faster, that's all. You were ready to finger somebody for me. Now I gotta figure out who it is the hard way. Kinley.
Sean, you're back.
Oh, my beautiful blonde.
Don't say a word. Let me wear those lips out for you, sweetheart. Oh. Baby, I have missed you. I can't keep up with you guys. What do? You're always leaving me. You never tell me anything.
Well, what do you mean, guys? I thought I was the only guy in your life.
Oh, really? Huh? Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Well, let me just tell you. First, you go off with no warning whatsoever to Washington. Not a word. Just no warning. And then you know what happened yesterday? Colton leaves me high and dry seconds before he's to go on the air. I have to run a rerun yesterday on the air.
Colton went somewhere?
Sweetheart, that's what I just told you. Yes, he did. He made a phone call. And then he just runs out. Clear blue sky. Doesn't say a word about anything. He does.
He didn't say where he was going.
Of course he didn't tell me where. Why should he tell me where he's going? I'm just his boss. You're just my fiance. No, where are you going? Why are you putting your coat on, Sean? I don't understand why you are so upset about this. I am the one that had to put the rerun on because you know, and I was wanting to know about this. I heard that there was like somebody that came up here that had multiple colored hair and she'd been up here quite a few times. And I don't know who she is, but I would like to. She has something to do. Oh, she? She? Now you're calling her at the office. That's very nice, Sean. I appreciate that. I want to know who this woman is. You haven't said a word to me about it.
Now,
are you going to talk to me?
Damn.
Are you going to talk to me? You're trying to change the subject, aren't you?
What?
I want to know what is going on. Who is this? You keep calling... Is she you're calling at the office? Who is it who has all this multicolored hair? And don't try to get out of this, because Prunella said that she was here.
I have no idea what you're talking about, and I can't really discuss it right now. We'll talk about it.
Let me get back. Where are you going? Where are you going? Sean, you just got back. Where are you going? I'm going to kill you. I'm going to strangle you. If I didn't love you, I would strangle you. Oh! What time do you have?
It's about 3 minutes later than the last time you asked.
Where are they? How can they stay in business if the shop is closed all the time?
Well, it's a pretty small shop. They may do most of their business by appointment. Or maybe they just overslept.
Or maybe it's the wrong place.
How many C and Al Bell gift shops could there be in Quebec?
They have music boxes that look just like this one. This must be the right place.
Yeah, I agree.
What's bothering you?
Well, I was just thinking, we're not the only people looking for Frisco, right?
LeBlanc proved that.
And the people that shot LeBlanc.
So?
So that raises two possibilities. The first is that somebody beat us to this place.
Oh, don't say that. That's the worst thing that could happen.
Now, the second possibility isn't great either. We have a music box, and that is the only possible lead to this shop. We could have been followed, which means that...
I'm a sitting duck. Oh, come on. Somebody open up.
I don't think we're going to accomplish much standing here pounding on the door. Come on, let's go.
No, we'll come back later. Didn't come all the way to come back to Sykes.
All right. Tell you what, let's go see the police, all right?
Okay, all right, let's go. You a question.
Oui, madame?
My name is Felicia Jones, and my husband is missing, and I need some information about an accident that happened about several months ago. It deals with an explosion, and I was wondering if you had any records or anything.
Anglais?
No, an explosion.
Parlez-vous français?
No, I don't, but I was wondering if you knew anything about an explosion, any records
or anything. Je ne parle pas l'anglais. Madame, je ne comprends pas.
An explosion, you know. Boom!
Pardon?
Boom!
Monsieur, le gendarme. Avez-vous ce nom qui parle anglais? Madame ne parle pas français.
Et vous?
Un peu.
Monsieur, un moment, s'il vous plaît.
Oui, merci.
Oh, very impressive.
No, not really. I think I asked him if there was somebody else that spoke English, but I may have admitted to smuggling, too. We'll find out.
May I help you?
You speak English.
Only in emergencies. You want to report an explosion?
No, not exactly. You see, we're looking for a relative. Kind of the black sheep of the family, if you know what I mean.
Oui.
Our cousin was lost several months ago, and we heard that there may have been a fire, perhaps an explosion.
You are a relative?
Cousin, yes.
Man or woman?
A male.
Drugs or alcohol?
Probably both, actually.
Colton.
Well, now we're going to have to be honest with the man if we want him to help us out.
When and where was your cousin?
We're not sure exactly where. He's probably been around for about 6 months now.
Monsieur, do you have any idea how many fires we have in a city this size over that period of time?
What about an explosion?
Many fires involve explosions, madame.
Well, what about an explosion without a fire?
Madame, you are welcome to look through all of our fires. And I will introduce you to the fire inspector's fires. But you must understand, it could take weeks to go through all of them.
crazy old man. You should open up.
Come on, again?